Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Wang. Here is the question. A, B, C, D are n by n matrices. A times B transpose and C times D transpose are symmetric. A times D transpose minus B times C transpose equals I. I here means identity, or we call it a unit matrix. This means all entries on the diagonals are ones and others are zeros. The question is, we need to prove that A transpose times D minus C transpose times B equals I. From the given condition, A times B transpose is symmetric. What does this mean? This means A times B transpose equals A times B transpose, then transpose. We use the transpose operation just to switch the product order of the inside part, then distribute T to each matrix. The transpose of B transpose equals B. The transpose of A equals A. We change the order. Similarly, from the second condition, C times D transpose is also symmetric. We can simplify to D times C transpose. This is the given condition. We take transposes on the both sides of this equation. Then we have D times A transpose minus C times B transpose equals I. We simplify all four results and move and restructure these four results. Then we have now we use these four results to construct a new equation. The product of two matrices on the left hand side. The matrix on the right-hand side is the identity, the unit matrix. So here, the order of each matrix is 2n by 2n. Why it is true? We can check it. For example, the first row times first column equals I. We use this result. A times dt, A times dt, minus B times ct, B times ct minus, equals I. The first row times second row equals zero. We use this result. The second row times the first row, the first column equals zero. We use this result. And the last result, we use this result to construct the second row times the second column, which is I. This is a very important result. Why it is important? The product of two matrices equals identity. This means the two matrices, they are inverses of each other. The first one is the inverse of the second one. The second one is the inverse of the first one. This means A, B, C, D, the new matrix, its inverse equals this. That means the product, they can switch the order. We have the same result because this is the inverse of this. Inverse term itself equals the identity. Now, consider the last part. The second column times, the second row times the second column equals I. This means negative C transpose times B plus A transpose times D equals I. What's the difference between this one and this one? Let's switch the order of the left-hand side. Then you can see this is the same as this. We have done the proof. That's all. Thanks for watching and see you next time.